We're teaching trainings because it's the fastest way for us to grow and the fastest way for our relationship to develop, the fastest way to walk arm in arm and arm and arm and arm and arm with all of our friends straight to heaven, as fast as we can go, taking everybody we can with us.
Whatever country we're in, whether it's the US or Hawaii or Japan and Taiwan and Hong Kong and Germany and Wales and India, wherever we're meeting for this workshop, it's this profound get-together. And the richness that's there and the sweetness that's there because of the different cultures. For me, it's just very exciting. You know, our brothers and sisters around the world, and it seems like this is what we're evolving to, is the family of man, is that we're all brothers and sisters here, and it doesn't matter what we look like, or you know, it's my brother, it's my sister, it's my best friend. It's like, how good is that?
Psychology of vision had helped me in my life by opening my heart. Like, it was very helpful to open my heart and to join with people, to be connected with people.
My life is just easier. It's easier, it's more successful, it's more enriched.
So psychology vision has been a godsend, really, because it's made my life so much sweeter and so much richer.
I feel that the work has given me my life back. Yeah, it just has opened up so many new thoughts, new ideas, new philosophies, new ways of connecting with friends and family. Yeah, and pathways, new pathways. Just a new existence in the world. And I carry it everywhere with me.
Sometimes I go through this and I'm like, oh my God, I'm getting older and this, that, and you know, there's so much else going on. And then I look at the potential that's available given the tools that I've received through Psychology of Vision.
It's not just the Psychology of Vision, it's the community of friends that I've made. It's like having people in my life who just, we're all on the same page somehow, even if sometimes, you know, I may be a page or two behind the people in front of me. Somehow we're all willing to learn, we're all seekers. And it's given me an understanding of myself that, you know, I am okay.
Human beings are so beautiful. So incredibly beautiful. And often it's at times when things are the worst that people are really the very best. When you hear some of the stories that people live through and survive through, and keep breathing, we're amazing. We're absolutely so amazing and so lovable and so inspiring.
You know, the people we work with, it's our community. It's like we work with our best friends, and we have this same goal, which is to help the earth and to realize ourselves in love and in spirit. And so, you know, how good is that? You work with your best friends to make a contribution to the earth where you give yourself wholeheartedly and creatively, and you just find better and better ways to make the earth a better place and build that stairway to heaven as a group of people, as a community, as learning to love each other. And you know, where we've kind of rebuilt our families, you know, where we do that in our individual families, but now we do it as an extended family. You know, I think it's part of our greatest abundance on this earth is our friends.
I can't possibly accommodate whatever need that she has, and felt guilty, and the guilt was driving me to go crazy.
Go crazy. Guilt and aggression go together.
Yeah.
So what if in the midst of that you go, okay, I'm just going to go love her?
Well, that would be great.
Let's say that back there in the midst of this fight, you know, I was there in my spirit form going, love her. Love her.
The thing that I like about Chuck is he's just a guy. He's not someone that's way far out of reach. He's just right here. And he's your uncle, or he's your brother, or your dad, or your grandpa. He's just a friend who's willing to help and do whatever he can to help you make a difference in your life or make a change for whatever you want.
And I guess one of the things I love most about Chuck is that he's so bloody funny, you know, so it makes it easier to heal because we look at ourselves with such humor, you know.
And Chuck just comes so much from his heart. And the other thing is he goes to such depths and then uses fantastic humor so that we don't have to stay down in the seriousness of it.
You know, the love of a good husband feeds everybody, feeds the kids, feeds the friends, feeds the community, it inspires. And sometimes it means taking that step forward and being out there first.
I'm happy to take that step.
Yeah, that's the guy energy. It's like, okay, marry me.
Marry me. Please.
Through his work, through the books he's written, the videos he's done, the tapes, all the products, I think he really reaches a lot of people who respond to his style, which is funny and down to earth and just great fun, you know, to be around.
Okay, so we're going to be having a joining session. In Psychology of Vision, we're starting to call them oneness sessions now. What we're doing in joining is we're remembering that we are already joined, that we actually are already one. It's the most amazing experience because you sit with another person and you join in a common cause to reach each other. Whatever issue is being brought up by the love, by the grace that shows up simply because of your intention.
I've just met Lency this session, and she's so bright and alive. Yeah, and I just see lots of light around her, and she's very open and gentle. And I can see her power, like the very first process. I could just see and feel the power and the energy that she brought up with the group and how she was able to hold the group until the moment was right to step through. It was awesome. It's perfect.
Lency has been so courageous. She's so unstinting in giving herself. She would go into any situation and be willing to transform it, to heal it, to find the truth in the situation. I think she's the most courageous person I know.
So wonderful that I think, I've got to write this down. This has got to be in my book. And I goes, oh, I did it again. Pull myself back. Ah, oh, just, yeah, incredible. Oh my gosh, just, how will I describe it to you? Yeah, and take myself back, and I went back and forth, you know, from duality to non-duality, duality, non-duality, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and I realized that teaching and writing were my two biggest defenses against that love.
I would compare her to the founder of Aikido, to the master of Aikido, and there was an energy of love that came out of him all the time. There was almost a visible light around him. And when Lency's working, that same energy, that same light comes out of her. And so actually, I think I learned more about Aikido from her than anybody else.
For me, she's very, she's very divine in a human way. And she really loves you and taking care of you and take the risk to help you even. She's so courageous, you know, saying things to people, and it's almost slam their ego just in front of them. And that kind of risk I really admire. And after, you know, she being able to do that and have a wonderful result, and the people got healed, and yeah, mighty, she's mighty.
Over the last 20 years, I have had many teachers. I have gone to hundreds of workshops, literally. I have learned the models of many, many people, and there are no two people I respect more than Chuck and Lency Spezzano. There have been simple things that they've been able to do, transformations within my heart and mind, that have made it possible for me to have true love in my life. I just wouldn't have had it without them.